Hello, I am Dr. E. Srinivasa, working as an assistant professor of physics. In this video, I am going to explain some concept of planar motion, that is radial and transverse component of velocity and acceleration, which is a syllabus for first BSc physics, first sem students. The learning objectives of the study are expression for radial and transverse components of velocity and acceleration and applications of radial and transverse components to uniform circular motion, centripetal force and aerial velocity. Motion of a particle along a curve. If any particle moving in the xy plane along the curve, it is represented by so p of xy at any instant of time, and the position of the particle at any instant of time is represented by op is equal to the position vector r is equal to xi x into I cap plus y into j cap, where I cap is the unit vector along x axis and j cap is the unit vector along y axis. First of all, what is the radial component of acceleration? The component of acceleration and also velocity, which is acts along the radius vector. The velocity or acceleration acts along the radius is called radial component. And what is the transverse or tangential component? The component of velocity and acceleration which acts tangential to this curve or perpendicular to this arc vector is the transverse or tangential component. Consider a particle moving along a curve in xy plane. Let the position of the particle is p of xy at time t, and it is given by the position vector r is equal to op is equal to xi into I cap plus y into j cap. Call this as equation number 1. The velocity of the particle is given by v is equal to rate of change of position vector. That is, velocity is rate of change of displacement. Here the position vector represents the displacement of the particle. So v is equal to dr by dt. The position vector at a time is also given by vector r is equal to r of t into r cap t, where r cap is the unit vector along the direction of the vector r, and velocity is given by dr by dt, that is equal to d by dt of r into r cap. So if we differentiate this equation, we get dr by dt into r cap plus r into dr cap by dt. Call this as equation 2. Using polar coordinates from the figure, x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. Hence, a vector r cap, unit vector r cap is equal to cos theta into I cap plus sin theta into j cap. Call this as equation 3. So from this figure, here the component of vector r along x direction is r cos theta, along y direction is r sin theta. So x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. Therefore, a unit vector r cap is equal to cos theta into I cap plus sin theta into j cap. So here, draw or perpendicular vector which is perpendicular to a vector r, and also the components of r perpendicular vector along x direction is r sin theta and along y direction is r cos theta. So the component of r vector is r cos theta along x direction and r sin theta along y direction. On drawing or perpendicular vector which is perpendicular to the vector r, then this is the angle 90 minus theta, then the component of r perpendicular vector along this direction is r sin theta and along y direction is r cos theta, because the magnitude of r perpendicular vector is same as the magnitude of this vector r. So draw r perpendicular vector r and having the same magnitude as shown in the figure. The components of r and r perpendicular along xy directions are also shown in the figure. So r perpendicular cap is the unit vector along r perpendicular. So r perpendicular cap is the unit vector of r perpendicular, which is along the direction of r perpendicular. Hence we can write the r perpendicular cap, that is unit vector, is equal to minus sin theta into I cap plus cos theta into j cap. So differentiating equation 3 with respect to t, we get, so dr cap by dt is equal to dr cap by d theta into d theta by dt. So dr cap by dt can be written as dr cap by d theta into d theta by dt. So dr cap by dt is equal to, so if you differentiate equation 3, so the equation number 3 is r cap is equal to cos theta into I cap plus sin theta into j cap. If you differentiate this, dr cap by d theta is equal to minus sin theta into I cap plus cos theta into j cap. So that is why we are applying, so dr cap by dt is equal to minus sin theta into I cap plus cos theta into j cap into d theta by dt. So dr cap by dt is equal to d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap. So because r perpendicular cap is equal to minus sin theta into I cap plus cos theta into j cap. For minus sin theta into I cap plus cos theta into j cap, we can write r perpendicular cap and also d theta by dt. Call this as equation number 5. Similarly, we can obtain the equation for dr perpendicular cap or dt is equal to minus d theta by dt into r cap. So call this as equation number 6. Substituting equation 5 and 6 in 2. So equation 2 is v is equal to dr by dt is equal to d into rr cap by dt, that is equal to dr by dt into r cap plus r into dr cap by dt. So if we substitute, then we get v is equal to dr by dt is equal to dr by dt into r cap plus, for dr cap by dt, if we substitute, d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap. So substitute for dr cap by dt, will get r into d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap. But dr by dt is the component of the velocity along the radius, that is radial component, and r d theta by dt is the transverse component of the velocity vt. Therefore v is equal to vr into r cap plus vt into r perpendicular cap, where vr is equal to dr by dt is called the radial component of the velocity, and vt is equal to r d theta by dt is called transverse component of velocity. Hence the velocity v is the sum of the two velocities at right angles to each other. One is radial component and the another one is transverse component. The acceleration of the particle is given by, we know that acceleration is rate of change of velocity, that is it is given by dv by dt, that is equal to d by dt of v. So v is equal to dr by dt into r cap plus r into dr cap by dt. Substitute for velocity here, we will get d by dt of dr by dt into r cap plus r d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap. So A is equal to, if you go and differentiate, we'll get d square r by dt square into r cap plus dr here, dr by dt 1 into dr cap by dt. 1 is d square r by dt into r cap plus dr by dt into dr cap by dt plus differentiate with respect to r dr by dt into d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap plus r into d square theta by dt square into r perpendicular cap plus r d theta into dt, then dr perpendicular cap over dt. So the same thing I have written here. So acceleration is equal to d square r over dt square into r cap plus dr by dt into dr cap by dt plus dr by dt into d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap plus r d square theta by dt square into r perpendicular cap plus r d theta by dt into dr perpendicular cap by dt. Substituting for dr cap by dt and dr perpendicular cap by dt from equations 5 and 6, we get here the equation 5 is dr cap by dt and dr equation 6 is dr perpendicular by dt. We'll get acceleration is equal to, write the first term as it is and the second term dr by dt. Instead of dr cap by dt, here d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap. So for dr cap by dt, d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap plus dr by dt into d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap plus r d square theta by dt square r perpendicular cap plus r d theta by dt. For dr perpendicular cap by dt, here minus d theta by dt into r cap. So substitute minus d theta by dt into r cap for d perpendicular cap over dt. So we'll get this equation. So A is equal to, the first term is as it is, second term is also as it is, the third term is also as it is, fourth term is also as it is, minus into plus is minus. And also d theta by dt into d theta by dt is or d theta by dt whole square into r cap. So A is equal to, so take the common as r cap. So this is d square r by dt square into r cap. Similarly, here minus r into d theta by dt whole square into r cap. From these two, this and this, take r cap as common, we'll get d square r by dt square minus r into d theta by dt whole square into r cap plus, again take r perpendicular cap as common. So dr by dt into d theta by dt, one term is here, and also dr by dt into d theta by dt, two terms are there. So 2 into dr by 2 dr by dt into d theta by dt we get, and also another one is r into d square theta by dt square. So if we take r perpendicular cap, we'll get r d theta d square theta by dt square one term plus these two terms, 2 into dr by dt into d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap. So A is equal to, once again, d square r by dt square minus r into d theta by dt whole square into r cap plus, this equation can be written as 1 by r into d by dt into r square d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap. So if we differentiate this equation, we will get the same term. Therefore, we can write r into d square theta by dt square plus 2 dr by dt into d theta by dt can be 1 by r into d by dt into r square d theta by dt into r perpendicular cap. And acceleration A is equal to AR into r cap plus 80 into r perpendicular cap, where ar is equal to d square r over dt square minus r into d theta by dt whole square is called radial component of the acceleration, and at is equal to 1 by r into d by dt into r square d theta by dt is called transverse component of acceleration. I have written the same thing here also. Next, the where r is equal to d square r by dt square minus r into d theta by dt whole square is called the radial component of acceleration, and at is equal to 1 by r into d by dt into r square d theta by dt is called the transverse component of the acceleration. So this is how we can get the expression for radial and transverse component of velocity and acceleration. Next, we will discuss the applications of the radial and transverse component of velocity and acceleration. The first application is for uniform circular motion. What is uniform circular motion? Any particle moving along the circumference of a circle with uniform speed, then it is called uniform circular motion. At every point, the velocity is tangential to the curve and it is perpendicular to the force. So here, there is an acceleration produced towards the center. Here, this is the acceleration. This acceleration is called centripetal acceleration, and the velocity is along this direction. Both acceleration and velocity are perpendicular to each other. Since at every point the direction of the velocity changes, then the particle is treated as moving with variable acceleration. That acceleration acts along the radius vector towards the center. That acceleration is called centripetal acceleration. Any particle moving along a circular path with uniform speed is called uniform circular motion. Consider a particle moving in a circular path with a uniform angular velocity omega. Since r is constant, here the radius vector is always constant, so dr by dt is equal to 0, because differentiation of constant is equal to 0. Therefore, d square r by dt square is also 0. Therefore, radial velocity is 0. Dr by dt is 0, radial velocity is 0, and the velocity is only transverse. Also, angular velocity is defined as rate of change of angular displacement, that is d theta by dt, is constant because it is moving with uniform speed. Hence, its angular velocity is also constant. So, differentiation of constant is 0. Therefore, d square theta by dt square is equal to 0. Hence, transverse component of acceleration, you are already derived, at is equal to 1 by r into d by dt into r square d theta by dt is equal to 0. So d theta by dt is equal to constant. So d square theta by dt square is equal to 0. Hence, transverse, this 0 into anything is equal to 0. So transverse component of acceleration is also 0. There is no acceleration tangential to the surface or a curve. There is an acceleration along the radius only, that is radial component. The radial component of acceleration is given by r is equal to d square r over dt square minus r into d theta by dt whole square becomes r is equal to here. So d square r by dt square is equal to 0. Hence r is equal to d square r by dt square is 0. Substitute for d square by r by dt square as 0 minus r into d theta by dt whole square. So r is equal to, we can take negative sign here also, r into d theta by dt whole square. So but d theta by dt is equal to omega, so r is equal to minus r omega square. This is the expression for the radial component of the acceleration. That means acceleration acting on the particle along the radius vector towards the center, that acceleration is called centripetal acceleration. So for a uniform circular motion, only radial component of the acceleration is exist and transverse component of the acceleration is zero. Here the negative sign indicates that the acceleration is always directed toward the center and is called the centripetal acceleration. The second application is centripetal force. We know that centripetal force is defined as a force which keeps a body moving with uniform speed along a circular path and it is directed along the radius towards the center. Since for a uniform circular motion, there is an acceleration acting toward the center, that acceleration is called centripetal acceleration. And also, according to Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma, there is a force acting along the radius vector towards the center, that force is called centripetal force and the velocity is always tangential to this curve. Consider a particle having mass m moving with a velocity v in a circular path of radius r. Then the acceleration acting towards the center called the centripetal acceleration and is given by a is equal to v square by r, but v is equal to r omega. So here a is equal to minus r omega square. Here also we can put negative sign. The negative sign indicates that the acceleration is always acting toward the center. According to Newton's second law of motion, f is equal to ma. So f is equal to mr omega square. This is the magnitude of the centripetal force. If we take a vector, there is a negative sign. So the expression for centripetal force is f is equal to mr omega square. For a satellite in orbit around the planet, the centripetal force is supplied by the gravity. The gravity between the Earth and the satellite provides the necessary centripetal force for a satellite moving around any planet.